Hello children, welcome to the class. Today in this video we are going to solve question number 9 and 10 from exercise 10.2. Now see question number 9. The diagram for the question is given in the book itself. XY and X dash Y dash are two parallel tangents to a circle with center O and another tangent AB with point of contact C intersecting XY at intersecting the tangent XY at A and the tangent X dash Y dash at B. Prove that the angle AOB is equal to 90 degrees. The complete diagram is given. We are going to do a little construction, and by using theorem 10.1 and 10.2 we are going to solve that the angle value of AOB is 90 degrees. Children, see the diagram we have done. And we wrote what is given and what we want to prove. We need to prove that AOB is equal to 90. First, we are going for a construction. Join O and C. It is not given in the diagram. We are joining the point O and C to get triangles from the quadrilateral PQBA. So, what we constructed? We joined O and C. Now let's start with the proof. First, I'm going to consider two triangles and I'm going to prove that those two triangles are congruent. Triangle PAO and triangle OAC. Now we need to prove that these two triangles are congruent. Look into your diagram. POA and AOC. So triangle number 1 and 2. For a point outside the circle EA, from there if I join two lines to the circle to meet at a point on the circumference of the circle, then PA and AC are tangents. And then by theorem 10.2, the length of these two tangents are equal. Then from the center of the circle O, there goes a line segment OP to meet the circle at P, and another line segment which we constructed OC to meet the circumference of the circle at C. Then what is OP and OC? Those two lines are radius, and for a circle all the radii are equal in length. Then what is OA? OA is common. Therefore by triple S congruency we are going to prove that the triangle PAO and triangle OAC is congruent. What is the first step? PA is equal to AC. How these two are equal? Tangents from the external point A. So one side we prove it is equal. The next is OP is equal to OC. These two are radii of the circle, another side is equal. And then what about OA? OA is common, the third side. Therefore, I can say that my triangle PAO is congruent to the triangle OAC by triple S congruency. Then by CBCT, I can say that. So in any two congruent triangle, what we know that all the corresponding angles are also equal. Here I proved these two triangles are congruent by all the sides. So all the angles will also become equal. Here it is point of connect, right? The meeting point of the radius and the tangent. So this is 90. The same way the corresponding angle here is also 90. Here these two angles, which is dividing the angle O here, the angle POC is also equal. And the same way I can say that angle PAO is equal to angle CAO. Angle 1 and angle 2, I am going to say that is also equal. Angle PAO is equal to angle OAC by CPCT. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal. Let it be your equation 1. The same way I am going to solve for triangle QBO and BCO, which is there in the down part of your diagram. I need to prove that these two triangles are congruent. QB is equal to QC, again tangent from the point Q, and OC and OQ are the radii. OB is the common line for these two triangles. Therefore, by AAA's congruency rule, these two triangles are also congruent. Then by we proved that the triangle 3 and 4 is also congruent. Again, by corresponding parts of congruent triangles, we can say that for these two congruent triangles, all the corresponding angles are equal. Here, we are going to take only the angle 4 and 3. We are going to take the angle 3 and 4 by CPCT. Angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Therefore, the angle CBO is equal to angle QBO by CPCT. Now, this as your second equation. Now, for these two tangents, XY and X dash Y dash, it is given that in the question that these two are parallel lines. If these two tangents are parallel, then what about AB? AB also, they said it is a tangent, but for a parallel line, what is AB? AB is a transversal. Now, for this transversal, if I take the interior angles on the same side, what is my first interior angle? Angle PAB is my first interior angle, and the second interior angle is angle ABQ. When I take the sum of interior angles on the same side of the transversal, that is equal to 180, right? So I can write that angle PAB plus angle ABQ is equal to 180. Now, what we derive from the diagram, for the two parallel tangents, since these two tangents are parallel, the other tangent AB becomes the transversal. And now, for this transversal, if I take some of the angles, now for this transversal, the angles PAB and the angle ABQ is equal to 180. How I can say that these two sum is equal to 180? By sum of the interior angles on the same side of the transversal. So we are going to rewrite angle PAB as the complete angle PAB is equal to angle 1 plus angle 2. PAB, I am writing as angle 1 plus angle 2, and ABQ, I am writing as angle 3 plus angle 4. Because we divided those angles as 1 and 2, 3 and 4, that is equal to 180 by angle sum property. And then from equation 1 and 2, from equation 1 and 2, we got angle 1 is equal to 2. So I am replacing angle 1 as 2. And from equation 2, angle 3, we got angle 3 is equal to 4, right? So I am replacing the angle 4 as 3, which is equal to 180. I got 2 angle 2 plus 2 angle 3 is equal to 180. So angle 2 and 3 is equal to 180 by 2, which is equal to 90. We got angle 2 plus angle 3 is equal to 90. The angle 2 is angle OAC and angle 3 is angle OBC. Therefore, OAC plus OBC is equal to 90. Now, we are going to consider the triangle AOB. In this triangle, sum of all the angles is equal to OBC plus AOB. All the three angles of the triangle is equal to 180. How we can say that? By angle sum property of a triangle, right? Now, OAC plus OBC, from my third equation, I got that as 90. 90 plus angle AOB is equal to 180. Therefore, the angle AOB is equal to 180 minus 90, which is equal to 90. Hence, proved. Children, I am repeating what we have done in this sum. The complete diagram is given. Only one construction we did. We joined OC. Then, from the OC divides the quadrilateral into two. In the above part, two triangles I took. And I proved that these two triangles are congruent. And from that congruency, I derived angle 1 is equal to angle 2. That is angle PAO is equal to angle OAC. The same way I did for the down two triangles also, the bottom portion of the quadrilateral. And I proved angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Then, I have gone for transversal concept and I proved that the sum of the angles on the same side of this transversal, interior angles on the same side of the transversal, that is this complete angle and this complete angle is 180. Since this 2 is equal and angle 3 and 4 is equal, I got angle 2 plus angle 3 is 90. Then finally I considered the triangle AOB and in this triangle by angle sum property, angle O plus 2 plus 3 is 180, right? And by my transversal concept, I got angle 2 plus 3 is 90. Therefore, the remaining is 90. We prove that angle AOB is equal to 90. See, question number 10 now. We need to prove that the angle between the two tangents drawn from an external point to a circle is supplementary to the angle subtended by the line segment joining the points of contact at the center. This is a proving sum. Come, let's see how to solve the sum. There is a circle and there is an external point for the circle P. From there we have drawn tangent T, PA, which is your tangent 1, and PB, your tangent 2. And we need to prove that the angle made by these two tangents at this external point is supplement to the angle made by the same tangent with point of contact and the radii at the center. So what does it mean? Angle AOB plus angle APB is equal to 180. We need to prove that. Now, what is point A? Point A is point of contact, right? What is point of contact? The meeting point of the radius and the tangent. And by theorem 10.1, this angle is equal to, at point of contact, the angle made is equal to 90. The same way, what is B? This is also point of contact and the angle made at this point is also equal to 90. So, from point A and B are point of contact and by theorem, do write the statement of the theorem here. By theorem 10.1, angle OAP is equal to angle OBP is equal to 90 degrees. At point of contact, the angle is equal to 90. Now check your diagram. What is OBPA? The complete 2D linear closed object. What is this OBPA? It's a quadrilateral, right? Since OBPA is forming a quadrilateral, what do you know about the sum of the angles of a quadrilateral is equal to 360. So what are those angles? Angle OAP plus angle APB plus angle BOA plus PBO is equal to 360. Angle sum property of a quadrilateral. Now, in equation 1, we got that value of angle OAB is 90 and value of the angle OBP is also 90. Therefore, in equation 2, we get 90 plus angle APB plus angle AOB plus 90 is equal to 360. Transpose the numerals to the other side of your equation, what we will get? Angle APB plus angle AOB is equal to 360 minus 90 minus 90. Therefore, angle APB plus angle AOB is equal to 180. We have proved that the angle made by two tangents from an external point is supplement to the angle made by the same tangent with point of contact and radius. That is AOB plus APB is equal to 180. We should.
Thank you, children. Catch you in the next video.